guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I walk, oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father, God the Son. Well, 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 I want to.
Desired of the Lord, that in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
Teach me.
thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path, because of my enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of my enemies. For false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty I have fainted unless I have believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. And he shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. And all the people of God said amen. Amen. Say amen again. Amen. Because we know God is good, say amen again. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made, and although we have sadness in our hearts, we yet rejoice because we know God is good. Amen. And we know that in spite of whatever else we might be going through, he is able to keep us at a time such as this. We've come to share with this family as they're celebrating the life of Mr. Wilbert Eugene Woods, amen. A life that has been lived, a life that has meant something to somebody as he lived. And as we come today, we come thanking God for his life, amen. The family has given us a program that we should use, and we do ask at the moment of family and friends coming for reflections, and those that you would like to come, if you have reflections, that you may come at that time. Pray with me now. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you now for this day. And God, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. Oh Lord, as we come to you, we come with our heads bowed and our hearts filled with sadness. And although tears are falling from our eyes in the midst of everything that we're experiencing, we yet want to tell you thank you, God. Thank you, God, for having mercy upon this family. Thank you, God, for looking down upon them and seeing them just where they are and giving them the comfort and the peace that they need in this hour. God, we realize and we know that even in this hour, there's so much sadness, but yet as we look to you, as we look to the hills, we tell you thank you. Thank you, God, for covering. Thank you, God, for keeping. Thank you, God, for blessing. Thank you, God, for traveling mercies for those who have traveled from afar. Thank you that you allowed them safe passage here. And even in the midst of celebrating this life, as we've come to celebrate Brother Woods today, we tell you thank you for his life. We tell you thank you for the man that he was as he lived amongst his family. We thank you, God, for those who loved him and those he loved. And we pray now that you would bind them together on one accord. realizing, knowing, oh God, that you are able to do all things. So God, we lift this family up to you. Have mercy upon them in this hour. And then God, as we celebrate this life today, help us to know that we too one day must go this same way. Help us now, oh God, to make preparation. For we don't know when and we don't know where, but we know it's soon to come. We ask all these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our scripture, amen, comes from the 34th Psalm. Psalm 34, verses 1, 2, and 3. It says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. And verse 3 is the verse that I want the family to. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Amen. Amen. At this time, we have a poem that is printed in your program as a tribute to her father. And although it won't be read, we ask that you would read that poem at your time. But we ask this a special tribute to a father from his daughter. So we thank God for those words that are printed there. At this time, we will have reflections from any family or friends that would like to come and share reflections. You may come at this time.
Taught me how to catch a football. Taught me how to be a man. Taught me many life lessons. I just want to let the church know I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you.
bosom of your heart, lift your voice. My hallelujah.
Bring joy to your heart. And I know he loved us and did not want to leave us, but it was just that time. So if y'all wouldn't be so gloomy, I'd appreciate it about the situation. Because he was not that type of person. He was always making somebody's life joyful. A lot of times when the nurses would come and see him, they wanted to be there. They were called to make sure that Wim was at the house so they could get their joy back from whatever they had been encountering through the weekend and the time. So y'all just, we're celebrating life. None of us are gonna stay here forever. We all are gonna pass this way. All of us. So I just don't want y'all to be sad, because I'm sure that's not what he wants.
Experience many things. And you know, life brings to us so many different things, and oftentimes as we're going through, we wonder sometimes, how do we make it through those moments, and how do we deal with the pain of living? Because life, in many cases, life brings us to the point we wonder, how are we going to make it? But you know, we learn to trust God. When we learn to believe and we learn to know that in every situation, in every circumstance, God is still in charge of all things, that helps us to deal with those things that we have to deal with. We give honor to God for our being here today, and to you, this family, and to other ministers that are present. We thank God for each of you who are here. And just to share briefly with you words of comfort, words of encouragement, words of hope, words of inspiration, that would help you to know that in this life, this is just a temporary time. We're only here for a little while. Very familiar passage of scripture coming from Psalm, the 23rd Psalm, verse number 1. It says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." And using that text, and just if you want to talk before, the Lord is. The Lord is. And when we begin to think about where we are right now and what you all are dealing with and how you are coming together as a family in this moment, it's easy for someone to tell you that it will be all right. It's easy for someone to say that, you know, it's going to be okay, it's going to be okay. But it's in that moment that you're experiencing what you're experiencing that it's hard to hear past "it's going to be all right." Because when you find yourself where you are, you're not really focused on what it's going to be after a while. You're focused on what you're dealing with in this moment. And oftentimes we get to the point of wondering, why are we going through this? And then once we're in the midst of going through it, we get into a pattern of having to wait. We have to wait and figure out, when is it going to get better? Because everybody that came to me, everybody that came by, told us it's going to be all right after a while. So when is it going to be all right? How do I know it's going to be all right? But in that moment of waiting, we also have to realize that that's when we have to know for ourselves just who God is. Because it's in that time of waiting that we realize that we become not just a person of waiting, but we become people of faith. Because you have to realize if you can't see it and you don't know what's behind it, you still have to trust God enough to know that he will bring you through it. And it's in that time of waiting that we find ourselves saying, "Okay, God, what are you trying to show me? What are you trying to tell me?" And as the song is saying, you deserve it. You deserve my praise. But how are you able to praise God, you think, when you're in the midst of going through what you're going through? That's when your praise becomes the greatest praise that you have. Because you realize that in the midst of my tears, there's still a God who's taking care of me. You realize that in the midst of what I'm dealing with right now, there's still a God who's able to lift me up above where I am and to help me to understand that while I'm crying today, I won't have to cry always, because he says in his word that he will wipe tears from my eyes. He will wipe the tears away. So when we begin to read Psalm 23, those three words, "The Lord is." The Lord is. And no matter what you put after that, the Lord can be whatever you need him to be. The Lord is a husband for those who don't have a husband. The Lord is a father for those who don't have a father. The Lord is a friend when there are no friends around. So whatever you are and whatever you're dealing with, the Lord is. And then, you know, when you begin to read the scripture, you begin to think about, then you have to ask yourself, who is the Lord? Who is the Lord? What is he like? Why is it that I'm able to go through what I'm going through, and when everybody around me is telling me that it's going to get better, they constantly tell me, but just trust in the Lord. Because when everybody else gets tired of coming to visit, when nobody else is texting you, DMing you, calling you on your telephone, calling to check on you, the Lord is still there with you. That's why you have to recognize that the Lord is with you in the midst of the good times. He's with you in the midst of the bad times. He's with you. Every step of the way. So when you begin to think about that, it also takes you from a place of wondering to a place of trusting. See, because when you wonder if the Lord can do it, you have to first go through it. And then once you've gone through it, you say, oh, I know the Lord can do it. But can I tell you that your faith ought to be so right now that you can look around and see that in spite of what I'm going through, I know that the Lord is going to bring me through this. I know that the Lord is going to bring me through. Because when you look around and see everything that everybody else has gone through, if he did it for them, surely he can do it for you. If he turned them around, if he helped them to get through, if he wiped tears from their eyes, because where you're sitting right now, you're not the only family that's had to sit on that seat. But there are those of us who can tell you that in the midst of my sorrow, in the midst of my pain, in the midst of my tears, the Lord was right there with me. The Lord was there with me. Well, Pastor, that sounds good, and you're telling me all that, but how do I really know that? How do I know that? Can I tell you, you're living it right now? Because you think about when you learned the news of Brother Wilbert's passing on May 13th, there was a sadness that took over you, and I'm sure there was somebody that said, Lord, what are we going to do? How are we going to get through this? Can I tell you, the same Lord that you asked how we going to do it is the same Lord that has kept you from going through this point where you are right now. When you thought that you were going to give up, the Lord was right there to carry you. He carried you through this. He carried you to the point of knowing that you couldn't walk by yourself, but he carried you. You didn't think you were going to be able to hold your head up, but he said that I am the God of the brokenhearted, that I am able to heal you in the midst of whatever it is you're going through. The Lord. The Lord is. The Lord is. The Lord is whatever you need him to be in this moment. And if I could tell you one more thing, I would simply tell you this. If you don't know him for yourself, today will be a good day to come to know him for yourself. See, because in the midst of your pain, when everybody else walks away, the Lord will still be there with you. And in the midst of not knowing what to say when you need to say certain things, the Lord will give you what you need to say in a time like that. In the midst of it looking like the tears will never stop falling from your eyes, the Lord will rock you and he will hold you and he will let you know that it'll be all right. Then in the midst of thinking that the night won't ever come and daybreak is never coming, he'll let you know if you can just make it through the night, trust in me, I am the one who can bring you through. And that comes from when you come to truly know who the Lord is. So family, I don't know what your circumstances might be. I don't know everything that you might be dealing with. But can I tell you that right now where you are, the Lord is speaking directly to your heart. The Lord is letting you know that the pain that you feel, it won't be there always. Because guess what? He's able to ease the pain. Can I tell you that when it seems as though there is no hope for tomorrow, he is the hope for tomorrow. Luck has nothing to do with it because he is your hope. He is your strength. The Lord is everything that you need.
Oh, my God, my God. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The Lord is.
The Lord is.
The Lord is. So if you take nothing else away from Wilbert's celebration and Wilbert's living, remember that the Lord, the same God that took care of him, is the same God that's going to take care of you. The same God that he woke up every morning playing that song, You Deserve My Praise, is the same God that deserves your praise right now. Because see, what you might not understand and what you might not even believe in this moment is that when you're able to praise him in the midst of what you're going through, when you're able to lift up your hands in the midst of what you're going through, when you're able to tell somebody, I know that the Lord will keep me in the midst of what you're going through, then that means your faith, you have moved from just being a person that heard about it, but you are now a witness to the fact that God will do anything. The Lord is. So family, trust in him. Trust in him in this hour. Trust in him knowing that the Lord is everything that you need him to be. And that he will safely carry you through. No matter where you are, no matter what your lot might be, then you'll be able to tell somebody, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. Pray with me now. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you in this hour for what you're doing for us right now. God, we thank you for your grace and your mercy, God. We pray that you'll have mercy upon this family in this hour. Comfort hearts, strengthen hearts, and allow them to know that you're everything that they need in this hour. God, we thank you for the life of Wilbert Eugene Woods. We thank you, God, for them passing this way. We're thankful, oh God, for those who had a chance to call them friend in this life. Now, God, that you permitted him to go a little sooner than we would want him to go, we pray that you will comfort this family, that you will keep your hand upon them and allow them to know in this hour that you will never leave them alone, that you will never forsake them. Thank you, God, for being the God of our joy. Thank you, God, for being the God of our hope. And thank you, God, for having mercy upon us in this hour. We ask all these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.